All right, so getting started today, look around your space. Make sure that you have the props that you need. You might want your blocks or a blanket to sit on. If that's more comfortable, we're gonna start doing some seated work. So position your body in a way that's most comfortable. If your knees are bent and that doesn't feel good, you can extend your legs in front. We're gonna have a fun class today where we really focus on our alignment so that our practice is very safe. So you'll hear me saying all the cues, you'll see me demonstrating some of the postures, and then you'll see me demonstrating alignment with our beautiful model today. So starting off with our breath work, as you come into your comfortable seat, just let your arms rest. So let the elbows bend. Your palms can be facing down if you need grounding. Or you can rotate your palms facing up as an intention of receiving. Let your eyes close. Reach the crown of your head up towards the ceiling. And feel your seat connected to the mat. So you're rooting down at the hips, rising up through the crown of the head. Straight spine. And try to position your shoulders above your hips and your ears above your shoulders. So to really get that straight spine, you can take your index fingers and your thumbs to your ears. Imagine someone standing behind you, pulling your ears back. Feel the spine lengthen, hold this shape, and then just release the hands back down to the thighs. With your eyes closed, start to focus on your breath. Just noticing how you're breathing naturally, without force or control. On your next inhale, take in as much air as you can. So you're breathing in all the way to the top of the breath. And once you get to the top of the breath, as you exhale, slowly release. Slow, slow, slow. So we're going to continue to breathe in that way, breathing with intention. You can take your hands to your belly. As you inhale, feel your belly pressing to your palms. Feel the belly expand. And as you exhale, feel the belly soften. Feel the belly button moving towards the spine. Inhale completely, all the way to the top of the breath. And as you exhale, slowly let it go. Continue to breathe in this way. So now we're calming our nervous system. We're down-regulating. We're doing this just by changing our breath. So now promoting peacefulness. And now we're in a great place to think about what our intention might be for our practice. Your intention could be something physical like strength or flexibility. Or your intention could be something else like peace or letting go. Just simply notice what's coming up for you. And let that be your theme for your practice today. Take a couple more full rounds of breath. Gently let the eyes flutter open. Just come back to your natural breath. without force or control. Just breathing as you usually do, without thought. As you exhale, tuck your chin towards your chest. Feel a stretch at the back of the neck. Pause here for another full round of breath. You might even feel the stretch going into the shoulders and the upper back. Now you have a choice. You can decide if you want to stay here, or as you inhale, you can take your right ear above your right shoulder. Exhale, chin to chest, and then take the left ear above the left shoulder. Inhale to one direction. Exhale, opposite direction. Keep your eyes closed. Notice how it feels as you move from side to side. Notice all the parts of your body where you feel sensation. Notice if one side is tighter than the other. And if so, you can pause there, hold for a longer amount of time. Really taking our time to open up the space, to release any congestion you might have in this area. When you're ready to move on, you can move to the other side and take a longer hold. And continue to move on when you're ready. Start to even out the sides. Eventually finding your way to center, chin towards your chest. On your next inhale, lift your chin, gaze forward. Back to that straight spine. Now take your hands outside of your hips. As you inhale, shrug the shoulders up to your ears. And as you exhale, take your shoulders back and down. Inhale, lift the shoulders up. Exhale, back and down. Inhale, lift, exhale, back and down. So let your movement follow your breath. Each time the shoulders come back and down, feel the shoulder blades moving towards each other, squeezing away stress and tension from the upper back. Let's take a couple more. And the next time the shoulders go back and down, just let the shoulders melt away from the ears. So we're going to continue with some shoulder work. We're going to pay special attention to our alignment and safety. If you have a block, go ahead and grab just one block. And you'll take the block between your two hands. So the short ends of the block are at your palms. Now extend your arms forward. Now the really great thing about this class and having a demo model is that now we see two different bodies. So if you have really broad shoulders, you have the option of taking a second block to give yourself a little more space. So you want your wrists in line with your shoulders. Okay? So try both of those. When you look at your wrist, you'll know if your wrists are wider than your shoulders. Pick the option to where you feel the wrists are more in line with your shoulders. Now, we're starting with the wrist in line with the shoulders. This is our starting point. As we inhale, we'll lift the block overhead. And as we exhale, we'll come back to the starting position. Inhale, lift. Exhale, back to the starting point. And again, movement following the breath. You might feel the shoulders firing up already. Stick with it. Let's take one more. And then we'll bring our block down. Just set the block down. Take a full round of breath. Now we're starting to wake up the shoulders with the movement that we just did. Now we're going to get some more fluidity. We're going to take some circular motions. Really get that shoulder working. We're going to do one side at a time. So I'll demonstrate by taking a block onto my palm. Now you're going to have a tendency to want to curl your fingers around the block and hold onto it. For this practice, I want you to have all of your fingers underneath the block. So you're holding the block like you're holding a tray. So let's try this together. Position the block onto your hand and make sure that you're not gripping with your fingers. Position the block so that you've got the long way in line with your fingers. All right. Now, we're doing this seated. It's okay if you drop your block. It's just a piece of foam. It's not going to hurt you or anyone around you, so don't be scared to drop your block. What we're working with here is how much mobility we can get in the shoulder. So start with your elbow beside your side body. So the elbow is bent. Bring it into the body. Now, send the block out. So you're straightening your arm. From here, you're going to bring the block back in. Bend the elbow, send the elbow out to the side. Lean forward to get the block under the armpit. Now, this is where it gets tricky. Press the block up towards the ceiling. Feel the wrist rotate. We're also getting mobility for the wrist. Turn the fingers facing forward. Lower the block down. Bend the elbow. Come back to your starting point. Good, let's try that again. We're gonna do two more rounds on this side. We'll send the block forward, arm is straight. Bend your elbow, bring the block towards your torso, lean forward, lean away from the block to create the space to move the block, circle it around, take all the time you need, and then find your way to your starting point. Now, bring the elbow in. Let's pause here. The trick is to keep this with one hand. If you're supporting with your other hand, then you're cheating a little bit. It's okay if you do that the first or second time just to feel it out. But this third time, let's try to do it with just our hand that's supporting the block. So here we go. Last time on this side, send the block forward. Now bend the elbow, bring the block towards your body. Send it out, take your time, there's no rush. Let the shoulder, the arm, the wrist move, fingers are forward, and then the elbow bends, and we bring it in. So with just that little bit of movement and focus, you probably felt a lot of work happening there in the shoulder, but this is a really gentle and safe way to get that mobility. So let's try that on the other side. Take your block, place it on the other palm. The hand that you were just using can now rest. Take a little check here. Make sure that you've got that straight spine. You don't want to be leaning forward. You don't want your head leaning forward. Remember, ears above shoulders, shoulders above hips. Super straight spine. This is axial extension. All right, starting now, opposite side. Look down, make sure the elbow is bent. Make sure the elbow is right outside of the side body. Starting our first round, send the block forward. The arm is straight. As you bend your elbow, lean forward, take the block in, move it up, twist around, bring it forward, fingers are facing forward, and then bring it in. Okay, let's pause here. So now we have a totally different side of the body. We know that our bodies are very asymmetrical. We brush our hair with the same hand. We use the same foot on the gas pedal. We use our bodies, different sides of our bodies, in different ways. So when we come into our practice, it's very common that one side of the body feels different than the other. For example, for me today, this side that we're working on now is a little more challenging for me. The side that's a little more challenging for you will feel like you might drop the block. Let yourself drop the block so that you can explore what your edge is in the practice. All right, we've got two more rounds. Starting off, send your hand forward. Maintain the block just on your palm. Bend your elbow. Bring the short end of the block towards the torso. Move the body around to support the movement. Let the wrist also come into play by rotating around. Bring it forward and then bring the elbow in. Pause for a round of breath here. We've got one more to go. Send the block forward. Bend the elbow. Send the elbow out. Bring the block in. Notice how you're using your torso to support yourself in this movement. And then we come back to our starting point. All right, good job. So we're gonna put the block down just for now. We're gonna continue on with our shoulders and our upper body. Now, this next movement that we're gonna come into is also gonna be incorporating some spinal twisting. So we'll take our fingertips to our shoulders and then lift the elbows. So you wanna have your elbows in line with your shoulders. Now the trick in this movement is to keep the elbows up. You'll notice that the elbows are gonna wanna sag down. So we'll start by moving both of your arms over to the right, and then let's twist to the left. Okay, so this is the movement that we're doing. So we're gonna make this a little bit faster. Just moving from side to side. Keep your hips grounded. Feel the hips connected to the mat. Keep the elbows lifted. Notice as you're moving from side to side, you're feeling the spine waken up. Anytime we do spinal twisting, we're detoxifying. Detoxifying physically, emotionally, mentally. Now is the time to start to let some of those things go. Whatever the things are that we've been holding on to for too long, just make an intention now of releasing and letting go. Challenge yourself and see if you can speed it up and move even faster. Keep the elbows lifted. I know this can be challenging. Keep the elbows lifted. Keep rotating from side to side. We're almost done, just a few more. You got this. Start to slow the movement. Find your way to center and let the arms come down. Just pause. We'll take a reflective pause. We might even close the eyes. And we just notice how the shoulders feel. You might even be feeling your biceps and your triceps. You might be feeling your spine, your back. When we liberate the spine, we can start to ease some of the tension, the muscles in the back space. Just taking a moment to integrate from the movement that we've done so far. All right, continuing with the upper body. Start to flutter the eyes open if the eyes are closed. Bring your hands in front of you, connect your palms, interlace your fingers. This is pretty easy when we do this in the front. Let's try this in the back. Take the hands behind you, let the hands go lower. See if you can interlace your fingers and press your palms together. If you cannot do this, then you can take your strap between your two hands. Okay, so if you need a strap, you can position it behind you. If you don't need the strap, then it's all good. So take the hands to the front, moving with our breath. Interlace the fingers, press the palms together. position the ears between the biceps. As you exhale, release the hands, take them behind you. Now, let the hands meet, fingers interlace, press palms together. On your next inhale breath, lift your fist. Open the chest, deep stretch for the shoulders and the upper back. Exhale, let it go. Release the hands, take the hands to the front. Interlace the fingers, press the palms together. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, release, take the arms behind you, interlace the fingers. Once the hands are connected, as you inhale, lift the fist up to your level of comfort. Exhale, let it go. Last round, take it to the front, fingers interlace. Lift up on an inhale. Exhale, let it go. Take the arms behind you, interlace again. And as you inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, let it go. Bring the arms out by your sides. Take the hands to your thighs. We're going to give our shoulders a break now. We're going to come into the side body. So we're going to take circles. With your hands just gently resting on your thighs, just pay attention that you're not pressing directly onto your knees. Now, we're going to take one side of our ribs. I'm going to start with my right side. To you, it'll look like the left because the camera's flipped. So I'll take the right ribs to the right knee. Now, as I inhale, I'll bring my chest forward, move over to the left, and as I exhale, I'll round the spine, bringing my belly button towards the spine, and then continue the circles. So this movement is called Anahata Kriya. Anahata means heart in Sanskrit. Kriya is a cleansing practice. Anahata Kriya. Kriyas are practices that are done by practitioners in India. Traditionally, they go through six different kriyas when they start their day. Now, I really like this movement because as you circle around, you will feel areas that are tighter. I like to pause and give that area time to stretch and open. Side body is the part of the human body that we stretch the least. So when we do a movement like this, we can tune into how much congestion we're holding. Now let's circle around opposite direction. As you switch up the circling, you might even feel different moving in this direction. You might find another area to pause and breathe into longer. Let your body explore this movement. This is our special time of the day that we've carved out for ourselves. This time where we don't have to rush, we just get to explore what it feels like to connect with our bodies. And with this time, intention and connection, we notice how the body's feeling today and what it needs. Take just a few more circles. Let the circles become smaller until eventually you come back to center. Now, once you find center, we're going to go a little deeper for the side body. So let's take our hands outside of the hips. Look down. Notice where that space is that your hand is in line with your hip. Now, you might notice that your fingertips come down. You might be able to bring your palms all the way down. This just has to do with the length of your arms. If you can't touch your fingers or your palm down, then you can bring a block so that you're bringing the floor up to you. If you don't have a block, you can use a pillow or whatever prop you have in your area to support you. So as you inhale, lift your arms up, fingertips towards the sky. Now as you exhale, go ahead and lower one hand down in line with your hip. Now the fingers that are reaching up, inhale, reach those fingers up as if you're trying to tap the ceiling. And as you exhale, lean over to your grounded hand. Pay attention to keep your hips connected. Don't come up off your seat. Now you might want to walk your hand further away from your hip because you might want to come onto your forearm. If that's not available, that's okay. Position your bicep above your ear. And then reach through the fingers. Now stay here. I'm just going to demonstrate how you can go a little deeper. So we've got a really nice example. We've got the bicep above the ear. We're reaching through the fingers. Reach, reach, reach. And while you're reaching, you're keeping your seat down. Creating space in the side body. Now we're getting ready to move on to the other side. So on an inhale breath, sweep both arms up, fingertips towards the sky. Now as you exhale, opposite arm is going to ground down in line with the hip. Inhale, reach the fingers up. Exhale, lean over towards your grounded hand. Positioning bicep above the ear, opening the side body. As you reach with your arm, keep your seat grounded. Breathe. See if you can come back to lengthening the breath, just like we practiced it at the start. Okay, next inhale. Both arms come up, fingertips reach up. Now that feels so good. We're gonna do it one more time on each side. First, set it up. Inhale, reach the fingers up, and then exhale, fold over. Reach, reach, reach. Notice how you can change the sensation of the stretch with how much you reach. Notice that the second side, the second time, you might be able to get into it a little deeper. On your next inhale, rise up. Fingertips reach up towards the sky. And then exhale, set it up opposite direction. Inhale, reach the fingers up. Exhale, reach over. Reach through the fingers as much or as little as you need today. This is your body. You're in control of how deep you want to go in your stretches. Next inhale, reach both arms up. And then exhale, take the hands down. All right, we've got one more seated posture. This is going to be for a deeper spinal twist. So just like we started in the last one, inhale, arms rise up. As you exhale, twist to your left. Take your left hand behind your spine like a kickstand. Take your right hand to your left thigh. Now practice looking past your left shoulder, looking behind you. Stay here for two more rounds of breath. Last round of breath. On an inhale, reach your arms up, bring your torso back to center. Exhale, now twist opposite direction. Set it up. Take the right hand behind the right hip. Take the left hand to the outside of the right thigh. Inhale, reach the crown of the head up. Exhale, twist deeper, look past your right shoulder. Hold here and breathe. Starting to come out as you inhale, lift the arms up. Torso to center, exhale, take the hands down. All right, we are going to transition now the station of our body from seated to kneeling. For those of you that have sensitive knees or have had any kind of knee surgery or just anything to where your knees need some extra support, this is where you can invite your knee pad or your blanket onto the mat. So I'm gonna demonstrate with that option. I'm just gonna take one of my blankets and open it up and position it right where I'm gonna place my knees. And we're coming into a tabletop position. So we're bringing our knees underneath the hips. And we're bringing our wrists underneath our shoulders. Now, when we come into this tabletop position, we want to spread the fingers wide. Press all parts of the hands into the mat. Now, lower your head, look between your knees. If you can see your feet, open them out until you can't see them anymore. This way, you can bring your ankles in line with your knees. Now, coming back to spinal mobility, as you inhale, let your belly lower towards the mat for extension of the spine. As you exhale, lift your back like a Halloween cat, as if you're trying to tap the ceiling with your upper back. Inhale, belly lowers. Tailbone lifts. Exhale, lift your back, tailbone lowers. Continue to let your movement follow your breath. Let your movement be exaggerated, but don't worry about moving your head. Just let your head naturally go where it wants to. Now we've got the option where we can continue this up-down motion, or we can take a little more freedom in our class and our movement today. You can start to circle the hips around. I really like this option because as the hips are circling around and starting to open up a little more, I'm also able to feel the wrists start to open up and warm up. There's some options we have coming up. Now, if you are on your hands and this does not feel good to your wrist, you can bring your blocks onto your mat and position your forearms onto the blocks. This way, there's absolutely no pressure on your wrist. So you decide how much you want to be supported. If you're circling around, go ahead and take the circles in the opposite direction. You'll notice if you make the circles bigger, you'll feel more into the hips. Just one more circle and back to center. So back to our tabletop. I'm gonna stay with the supported option for those of you that are on the blocks so that we're demonstrating two different options. Now we're just gonna move one leg at a time. Go ahead and lift off of your right knee, bring your right toes to the back of the mat. If your foot came off the mat, you can shimmy forward to use more space on your mat so that you have the cushion underneath your feet, that'll feel more comfortable. Now with your right toes connected to the back of the mat, pay attention to keep your shoulders above your wrist and press your right heel back. Feel a really nice stretch for your calf muscle. Hold and breathe. On your next inhale, lift your right foot up. And as you exhale, cross it over your left leg. Take your right toes to the outside of the left side of the mat. Good. Now with your toes down, turn your head to look over to the left. Look back to your foot. Press the heel back. Feel a nice stretch in the side body. On your next inhale, lift your right leg, bring it back to center. Exhale, bend your knee, bring it back down underneath the hip. Take a round of breath here. Now lift off the left knee, bring the left toes to the back of the mat. Once the toes are connected, press the heel back. Keep the shoulders above the wrist or shoulders above the elbows if you're using the support of the blocks. Feel a stretch of the calf muscle. On your next inhale, lift your left leg. Exhale, cross it over the right. Take your toes over to the right side. Now, look past your right shoulder. Look back to your foot. Hold and pause here. Feel the side body. Inhale, lift the leg. Bring it back to center. Exhale, bend the knee. Bring the knee down. And take a full round of breath here. Now, if you're on the blocks, you can go ahead and remove them. We're going to come into a hip opener. Look to your knees. Open your knees the width of the mat. Bring your big toes together. Send your hips to your heels. Setting up for child's pose. Now walk your hands forward. Lower your forehead down to the mat. Keep your forehead connected to the mat. Stay as you are. See if you can relax the hands down. Now this is a posture where if you have someone practicing with you, you could get an assist by pressing onto the sacrum. You want to think about getting your hips as low to your feet as possible. Child's pose is a posture that we want to spend a longer amount of time in. Child's pose is really beneficial for calming the nervous system. It's also a really great posture if you're having trouble sleeping or if you're having anxiety. So this posture really helps to calm the nervous system. And at the same time, when we have the knees open wide, we're able to gently open up the hips. Let's take one more round of breath. And maybe rock your forehead from side to side, just giving yourself a little massage at your thinking space, your third eye, space of intuition and intellect. And then lift your head, lift your hips, come back to tabletop. Now, in our tabletop, we're going to grab onto our blocks. Invite both of the blocks on at the highest height. Take your hands to the blocks. Now, this is giving us lift so that we can work one leg through. Now, this can be quite challenging, so take your time. Just lift your knee and then step it forward. Now, as you step your knee forward, press your hips forward. So you want your knee tracking above your ankle. If your knee is coming past your ankle, or especially your toes, then you can shimmy your foot forward. Now, as you press your hips forward, feel a nice stretch happening at the psoas, at the front of the leg that you have behind you. Stay where you are. I'm going to demonstrate some different options. So to be fully supported, you can have your hands on the blocks. To go a little deeper, you can take both of your hands to your thigh, making sure that you're not pressing to your knee. Press the hips. Another option is you can reach your arms straight up, fingertips towards the ceiling. Keep pressing the hips forward. If you want to come back to your shoulders like we did at the beginning of class, you can bring your arms behind you. Interlace the fingers. Open the heart. Start to squeeze away tension from the upper back. So we've got lots of options. Take the one that feels best for you in your body today. Now, whatever option you came into, go ahead and bring your hands back to the blocks. Fully supporting yourself. Send the hips back just enough to where your hip is above your back knee. Now, straighten the front leg, lift your toes. You might walk the blocks back so that you can maintain them under your shoulders. Now, just point your front toes, feel a stretch at the top of the foot. Take your toes over to the right. Take your toes to the left. Notice how this feels for your foot. Bring it back to center. Release the point, just relax the foot. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, bend your elbows. Hold your torso towards your front leg. Now, some of you might want to just let go of the blocks and bring your fingertips or your palms down to the mat. If that feels a little uncomfortable, know that you can always come back to the blocks. Now, we're feeling a deep stretch in the hamstring of the front leg. If your hands are not quite touching down, you can rotate the blocks to a lower height. So play around with your props. Fully support yourself. Notice that the more you fold, the deeper you're feeling the stretch. So again, you decide. Find that sweet spot. Find that place of deep stretch, but not to the point where you feel pain or major discomfort. Notice that the longer you stay, the more you're opening up. Inhale, rise up, bend the elbow, come back to your knee, down lunge. Now, take the knee back in line with the back knee to where our starting point was. Now, the opposite foot is going to come forward. Take your time to step that foot forward. Bring it to the top of the mat, knee down lunge, knee is bent. Remember, shimmy the foot forward to get the alignment of the knee above the ankle. Press the hips forward. Hands can stay on the blocks. Hands can come to the thigh. Press your hips forward. Fingertips can reach up towards the sky. Hands can come behind the back. You decide what feels good in your body. This posture is called Anjanasana. Knee down lunge. Breathe. Check your breath. Notice if you forgot to breathe, that's a really easy thing to do when we're thinking about lots of things happening in our body. Come back to that breath awareness. Wherever your hands are, take them to the blocks. Pressing down on the blocks for support, send the hips back just enough to position the hip above the back knee. Straighten the front leg. Walk the blocks back if you need to, thinking blocks under shoulders. Toes are lifted. Now, point your toes, get a nice stretch at the top of the foot, point the toes over to the left, and then over to the right. Notice where you feel the stretch, and then release the foot so you're not pointing or flexing. Take an inhale breath, and as you exhale, bend your elbows, fold your torso towards your front leg. Now feeling into this hamstring. Decide if you want to abandon the blocks and bring your palms or your fingertips down to the mat. If your hands don't quite make it, take the blocks to the lowest height so that you can really press your palms down. Remember, we're practicing safety with our alignment today. Find your edge. Give yourself a challenge, but not to the point of pain. One more full round of breath. Inhale, lift the head. to our knee down lunge, Anjanasana. Now we're gonna take the front knee to meet the back knee. Bring both knees in line with each other and position your shins on your blanket if you're working with a blanket. We're gonna come into another variation of child's pose. This one is for the low back. Set your blocks aside for now. Now with your knees together, feet together, bring your hips down to your feet. In this variation of child's pose, we're gonna bring our arms by our sides and our forehead down to the mat. Now if your forehead doesn't meet the mat, you can position a block underneath. If you've got a lot of space between your hips and your feet, you can position a blanket there. Now let the arms fully relax by the sides, giving the shoulders a break. Now we're finding flexion in the spine. Decompressing the spine, creating space, and releasing the low back. Connect with your breath. Settle in. Time for a reflective pause. In this shape, as you inhale, feel your belly pressing to your thighs. And as you exhale, feel the belly soften. Slowly and carefully start to come out. Inhale, lift your head. Exhale, take the hands to the mat. Come back into your tabletop position. Now, if you're working with a blanket, this is where you're going to want to let it go. Changing the station of our body from kneeling to standing. Now, to get to a standing position, you can walk your hands, one hand placement in front. Curl your toes, lift your hips way up high for downward facing dog, and then just walk your feet towards your hands. You can also use the support of a chair to help you rise up if you need to. Taking your time, walking your feet towards your hands, bring your palms to your shins, take a half lift, see if you can straighten your legs, and then as you exhale, let the arms dangle forward fold. Now you can let your arms dangle here, or you can take your hands to opposite elbows, framing your head with your arms. If your hamstrings are tight, you can bend your knees. If your hamstrings are open, your legs are going to be straight. If your hands are connected to your elbows, you're going to get more traction for your spine. This is a really great posture to do in the morning, especially if you're having back discomfort when you get out of bed in the morning. Now, for those of you that have really open hamstrings, you can bring your feet together and you can take your arms behind your legs, forehead towards your knees. Only if your legs are straight and your hamstrings are really open. Now, wherever you are, release your hands. Bring your hands in front of your feet. If your hands don't meet the mat, you can take a block. I'm going to demonstrate without the block, so we have different options to look at. Bend your left knee. Walk both of your hands to the outside of your left foot. Keep the right leg straight. Take the block with you if you need. Deep bend in the left knee, right leg is straight. Rotating your torso to the outside of the left leg. Remember, deep bend in the left knee, right leg is straight. Press that right foot into the mat. Feel a stretch traveling up the right leg into the right hip. Breathe. Exhale, bring your hands to center. Bend both knees. Take the block with you if you're working with the block. With both knees bent, walk your hands to the outside of your right foot. Keep the right knee bent. Straighten the left leg. Remember, the torso is rotated over to the right. Deep bend in the right knee. Press the left foot into the mat. Feel the sensation going up the left leg into the hip. Breathe. Bend both knees, walk the hands in front of the feet. Inhale, take a half lift, palms to the shins, reach the crown of the head forward, reach the tailbone back. Exhale, back to forward fold. Now look at your feet. Lift your right foot, cross your right ankle behind your left. Shimmy both hands over to the left, a little more if you need to, and fold. Now in this fold, try to keep your legs straight. Notice your breath. One more round of breath. Your blocks are there to support you if your hands don't meet the mat. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, right foot meets the left. Forward fold. Notice the hamstrings. They might be feeling a little more open now. Inhale, take a half lift. Lift the left foot, cross the left ankle behind the right ankle. Shimmy the hands over to the right and fold. Keep the legs straight. Use your props. The props are there to help you in your practice. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Inhale, half lift. Left foot meets the right. Exhale, fold. Now bend the knees, slowly, slowly start to roll up. Take three full rounds of breath to slowly come into a standing position. Head comes up last to prevent you from being dizzy. Now as you come into a standing position, look down, make sure your feet are together. Big toes are touching, just a little space between the heels, maybe half an inch. Inhale, reach the arms up. Let the palms connect. Now, as you exhale, take both arms over to one side, ears between the biceps. Send the hips away from the arms. So if your arms are to the left, send the hips to the right. Coming back into the side body and also testing your balance. Inhale, arms rise up to center. Exhale, opposite direction. Breathe. Inhale, center. Exhale, bring the arms down the midline. Now looking at your feet, open your feet hip distance. So when you look down at your feet, there's enough space for one more foot of yours to fit there. Come to the top of your mat. Take your hands to your hips. Now lean into the right foot, step the left foot way back so that you're just coming onto your left toes. We're coming into our crescent lunge. The left heel is lifted. Now, if you feel a little wobbly, this is where you can bring your hands to a wall space in front of you, or you can take your hands to a chair. If you feel okay in the free space, you're gonna lift your fingers up. Now, stay here. We're gonna talk about the alignment. We want the back heel lifted. You can step your toes back even a little more, yeah. And then you want your front knee above your ankle, and you want to be able to see your big toe and your second toe, so you don't want your knee coming in. Now you can stay still, or you can challenge yourself by bending your back knee on an inhale and straightening your leg on an exhale. If you like that challenge, you can take two more. Otherwise, you can stay in your static pose. One more if you're going with the movement. and we meet back at our crescent lunge. From here, transitioning now into warrior two, rotate your back foot to 90 degrees, open the arms. Now, before we do anything else, look at your feet. You can position heel to heel alignment or front heel to back arch. Now, fingers are reaching in opposite directions. Stay here. Press to the outer edge of your back foot, the pinky edge of your foot. Look to your front middle finger and make sure that you've got that front knee open rather than coming in. Okay, a lot of engagement here in warrior two. Breathe. On your next exhale, lower your back hand to your back thigh. Inhale, reach your front fingers up and then overhead. So you're reaching your arm back. Now you've got options here. You can reach the fingers up, or you can go deeper by reaching overhead. You can even take your back arm behind your back if you'd like. This is just an option. Take what you need. And then rotate back to warrior two. Now press into your front foot to straighten your front leg. Reach your front fingers forward and then rotate your arms for triangle. Now in your triangle, make sure your front leg is straight. The back of your palm can be at your inner thigh. Some of you might reach a block. Reach the top fingers up as if you're trying to tap the ceiling. Breathe through it. Now keep the legs as they are. Just rotate the arms back to warrior two. Keep the legs as they are. We're going to reverse our triangle. Straighten this leg. So we're taking the arms in the opposite direction. Now reaching up with the top fingers. And from here, we'll come back to warrior two. This means the front leg is going to bend. Front knee bends. Bend your right elbow. Bring your forearm to your thigh, not your knee. Reach your left fingers up and then reach overhead. This is extended side angle. Stay here. Long line of energy from your left foot to your left fingertips. So the top palm is facing down to the earth and the bottom palm is facing up to the sky. Stay here if this feels good. Some of you might want to go for a bind, taking your arm behind your back and fingers reaching for the inside of your thigh. Breathe. Don't forget to breathe. Come back to warrior two. Inhale, bring your arms up as you straighten your front leg. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, arms rise up, leg straightens. Exhale, it's warrior two. One more round. Now let's meet with our arms up, legs straight. Rotate all 10 toes in the same direction. Bring your hands to your hips. Look at your feet. Make sure your feet are in line with each other. Now, notice how your legs feel. If your legs feel like they're about to split open, then shorten the distance between the feet. If you're not feeling very much at all, open the feet wider. All right, hands are at the hips. Inhale, open the chest, bring the elbows towards each other. Exhale, fold forward. So we're coming into a wide-legged forward fold. Take your hands from your hips down to the mat now. Press to the pinky sides of your feet. Release your head and your neck. Let the top of your head face down to the ground. With your body in this position, imagine that any excessive thoughts that have been in your mind are just dumping out of your head into the mat, into the ground, into the earth, releasing from your being. Notice the inner thighs. Now, if you want to come back into the shoulders, you can take your hands behind your low back. Interlace your fingers, press your palms together. Remember, you can use a strap if the hands don't meet. And then lift the fist up to the ceiling. Now you decide how much, how deep you want to go. Breathe. Let the hands come down to the low back. Release the hands. Now, from this position, take your hands to your hips. As you inhale, lift the crown of your head up so you're back into a standing position. Now, because we're working with safety today, we're going to heel toe the feet closer together. And then we're going to walk the feet to the top of the mat. Back to our starting point. Now, taking these options on the other side. So now leaning weight into the left foot, lift the right foot, step the right toes way back. We're coming into our crescent lunge. We want to be on our right toes. We want the left knee bent with the left knee tracking above the ankle. And then the arms rise up unless you're using the support of a chair or a wall in front of you. Now remembering in your crescent lunge, the front knee is above the ankle. We have the option to stay still. Or on an inhale, we can bend the back knee, and then on an exhale, we can straighten the back leg. This is totally up to you. Couple more. If we're taking the movement, we've got one more. Now, once the leg is straight, we're going to bring the hands down to the hips. We're going to rotate that back foot to 90 degrees. Now we're setting up for our warrior two. So we can check the alignment. We can have heel to heel, or we can have heel to arch. This is up to you. I recommend trying both. See which one feels more stable. And then let the arms fly. Gaze to the front middle finger. Press to the pinky edge of the back foot. Warrior two. Make sure that when you look down, you can see your big toe and your second toe. A lot of engagement happening here. Breathe through it. And on your next exhale, let your back hand lower down to your thigh. Inhale, reach the fingers up. Now, option to stay here or option to reach back to go a little deeper for the side body opening. This is up to you. Keep that front knee bent. Sometimes we forget to do that. And breathe. Now, rotate the arms back to warrior two. Press into that front foot to straighten the front leg. Reach the front fingers forward and then rotate the arms for triangle. Reaching the top fingers up. Imagining that your back and your hips are up against a wall. Breathe. Now keep the legs as they are. On your next inhale, just rotate the arms back to warrior two position. We're going to reverse our triangle. Keep the front leg straight. Reversing our triangle, we're going to lower the back arm. Reach the front fingers up. Reverse triangle. Triangle in Sanskrit is Trikonasana. All right, so coming out of triangle pose, back to warrior two. This means we're bending that front knee. Now coming into extended side angle, bend the front elbow. Bring the forearm to the thigh. And then reach the top fingers up and then overhead. All right, now long line of energy on this side, from the foot to the fingertips. We've got the option to stay here. Or we've got the option to bring the arm behind the back. Other arm. Mm-hmm. Now, pay attention because if this doesn't feel good for your shoulder, then this isn't going to be a good option for you. Then you can come into the first option. If you have any kind of shoulder limitation, just be really careful.
palm face up.
Breathe. Feel the engagement of this position. If the arm is behind the back, lift the arm straight up. And then we'll come back into our warrior two. Now press into that front leg, straighten the front leg, rotate all 10 toes facing the same direction. Now we're facing the opposite side of the room. Look down to your feet. Make sure your feet are in line with each other. Now from here, bring your hands down to your hips. Look at your feet. Rotate your toes out, heels in. Take your hands to your thighs and sit back. So take your hands to your mid-thighs. So we're in a goddess squat now. Take an inhale breath with your torso at center. As you exhale, take that right shoulder to dip. Inhale, center. Exhale, left shoulder dips. Back to spinal twisting. Inhale, find center. Each time you exhale, opposite shoulder dips. Just take one more on each side. You can challenge yourself by lifting your toes if that's available. If not, you can set them back down. And once you've evened out the sides, you can take the heel of your hands to the hip crease, sit lower, see if you can straighten your arms. If you have really long arms, this might look different. And then we'll come back into a standing position when you're ready, wide legs. Now the toes went out, the heels in. Let's bring the heels in line with the toes. Bring your hands to your hips. Inhale, open the heart, elbows back. Exhale, dive forward. Back to our wide-legged forward fold. Hands come down to the mat. Now we're gonna move from side to side. So looking at your hands, walk your hands to your left foot, bend your left knee, press your entire right sole of your foot to the mat. When you're ready to move on, bend your right knee, walk your hands to your right foot, left leg is straight now, press the sole down. Continue to move from side to side. If you can go deeper, you can rotate the toes of your straight leg up, if that's available in your body. If not, stay with option one. Feel a deep, deep stretch for the inner thigh. And start to even out the sides. Find your way to center. Take your hands to your hips. And as you inhale, lift the crown of your head up. Once you feel stable in your standing position, heel toe the feet towards each other. And then rotate to face the top of the mat. Now from our standing position, we're going to come back down onto the mat. So you decide how you want to get there. Some of you will use the support of a chair or another prop. If you're okay to come down from the free space, you can inhale, arms rise up, and then exhale, dive forward, forward fold. Bend the knees to connect the palms. Step one foot back, coming onto the shin, and then the opposite foot. Bring the feet out to one side so that you can come onto your seat. Coming into our cool down phase, we are done with our standing positions. Just take a moment to reconnect with your breath, check and see how your body is feeling. And then bring the legs in front of you. Take your hands outside of your hips. Inhale, reach the arms up, so we're making our body in the shape of the letter L. And exhale, hinge at the hips, bring your torso towards your legs. Now, it's really important that the legs don't pop up. So don't stress about reaching too far. If you have a strap, I'm going to demonstrate how you can do this really safely. The strap would come around the feet, and then the hands would meet the loops of the strap. This way we can keep the legs down. The only space you should have at your legs is that natural space underneath the back of the knees. Now with each exhale, you can challenge yourself to see if you can fold a little deeper. Two more rounds of breath. Find your fullest expression. You can even reach further down since your elbows were bent. Now release the strap, and on an inhale breath, slowly come up. Relax the hands. All right, giving our legs a break, we're going to come into the upper body. We're going to take a supported fish. Two different options. A more gentle option will be to take the short ends of the blocks together. I'm going to set up two different options to show you. Those two blocks are going to go underneath the shoulder blades. If you're a lady, you're going to think about the space where your bra strap is. For a more intense option, you're going to take the mid-height of the block underneath your spine with the second block supporting your head. So let me show you what both of those look like. And if you come onto your blocks and the edges don't feel good, you can always fold up a blanket to have instead. All right, so you're gonna actually sit away from the blocks. Position your shoulder blades on top. Make sure you don't have your neck on the blocks. Let the legs rest and the head comes down. This is gonna be more gentle. And for those of you that have a lot of tension in the upper back, then a better option for you is gonna be to take the spine of the block underneath your spine, making sure that it's not on the low back or the neck, and then the second block can support the head. This might feel a little intense at first. Breathe through it. This is a heart opening posture. Heart openers are great postures to take if you need an emotional release. Just know that if anything arises, that's okay. Just take this time to observe. Remember that if the blocks are too intense, you can always use the blanket. Blanket would be positioned underneath the same part of the body. With each exhale breath, focus on letting your entire body just melt down, feeling the support of the props underneath you. Reconnect with your breath. We'll just take a couple more rounds of breath here. The supported chest heart opener. For the next couple rounds of breath, you can take your arms out to the sides. Wrist in line with the shoulders if you'd also like to get into shoulder opening. Now, if at any point that becomes a little too much, if you feel any tingling or numbness in the arms, then you're gonna wanna bring the arms down. Typically, tingling and numbness is an indication that a nerve is being compressed, and we don't want to hold that because we don't wanna cause nerve damage. So always scanning and listening to what your body needs and what it's telling you. And at this point of our practice, we have come into our Shavasana time. Shavasana is all about relaxation. So when you're ready, bring your arms by your sides. Lift your head, lift your back just enough to remove the props from underneath you, coming onto a flat back onto the mat. Make sure to move your hair around so that you're really comfortable. Let there be space between your feet, space at the armpits. If you've got issues with your low back, you might want to position blocks underneath your knees. That'll be a little more comfortable for the low back. Tuck your chin towards your chest. Feel the length of the cervical spine. Let your eyes close. Let your entire body be heavy. This time, this pose is all about relaxation. Feels really nice to have a blanket on top. Blanket is very nurturing. Also, because we're not moving anymore at this point in our practice, the temperature can feel a little cooler in our bodies. This time of our practice is all about being present with ourselves. Yoga teachers and yoga schools say that Shavasana is the most important posture. It gives us permission to just be. There's nowhere that we need to go. There's nowhere that's more important than being in our own bodies right now. We've got 1,440 minutes in each day. Know that it is perfectly okay to take 10 minutes for yourself. Know that this time that you invest in just being, relaxing, and practicing presence is setting you up to better serve other people that you come into contact with in your day. Making sure to serve yourself with this self-love and relaxation. Just breathe. Relax. At any point you find a lot of thoughts passing through, just practice letting the thoughts go just as easily as they come in. Know that if it's something important, it'll come back later in your day. But for now, just rest. Give yourself permission to stay in this resting pose for as long as you'd like. We'll close our